Hi guys, I'm Naman. I got placed at Flipkart ATM. ATM is their flagship program, which is basically, and ATM is an acronym for Associate Product Manager. You would have probably heard of Google ATM, which is like a globally reputed program. It's basically kind of a replication of that, but in an Indian firm, which is a startup. So I'll try to give you a glimpse of what product management is and like what is the role of a product manager in a company. I guess from what I know, product management started in ENG, where they started this role just to make sure that the products that they are creating are in line with what the customer wants. And later it moved on to more tech companies. Most of these tech companies which have like a really dynamic requirement of what customers want from day-to-day basis have product managers, and product managers are a really integral part of companies like Google, Facebook, Uber, Amazon, Flipkart, and everything. So the basic day-to-day job of a product manager will look like talking to stakeholders involving the sales people, maybe the customer representatives, the developers, or the finance people, and trying to see what the customer is actually looking for in the product, trying to implement in the product. In addition to that, another part of the product management job will involve ideating on what the next thing for the whole product is going to look like. This ideation does not come as a part of Flipkart ATM program as such, because those decisions are taken at a higher level. But you will be involved in the execution of it, you will be involved with working with developers. You'll have a team of developers working with you whom you want to guide through and make sure that you hit the product deadline on time. So this is how a product management job at a tech company looks like. Talking specifically about what are the skills that they're looking for, you need to be able to communicate your thoughts very well. You need to be able to communicate to the team with whom you'll be working with. You need to be on spot and keep a track of what's going on, so that you know how customer behavior is changing over time. Initially, the product management roles required you to be an industry expert, so that you have seen how the customers have grown from some point to now. But from this recent programs, they try to teach you this teach you this experience through this 2 years program is what I guess. Coming to how to get selected into this, basically the selection procedure is slightly different from how a consult or any other normal company selection procedure will look like. They'll have some form of a product management workshop in August or sometime, where they'll teach you basics of product management. They'll help you solve cases. A normal case will look like if you have to redesign Google or Gmail, so how will you go about doing it? So think about the everyday things which you use in daily life, and try to see what are the changes you would want to bring to them. What are the things, what are the ways in which that could have been redesigned, so that the objective of that product could be met in a better way or more efficient way. So if you do this exercise, you will be more like, this is what a general product management does on a daily basis. After that, they'll have some form of a deck submission. A deck submission will basically revolve something around, they'll ask you to identify a problem which you see in products around you, like maybe you take Zomato, Uber, or anything, and try to come up with a solution for that. Let's say you find some problem with Uber. Just to pick an example, Ola Play, I'm taking Ola Play as an example here. So if you think customized music for the writer is one problem which you see, so then you need to come up with a solution through which you can integrate that in the product. So that is basically the submission, and you have to make a presentation on this and submit it on the portal. From what I know, that is the only way through which they shortlist, and they don't consider much of the resume in already shortlist view. But I've heard mixed reviews on it, and I've seen that they go through a checklist, they go through the resume once again to make sure a sanity check is done so that the shortlist is on the point. After the shortlist is declared, like, which is a pretty small size as compared to any other company, I think 10 people got shortlist last time. Okay, 12 people got shortlist last time. After the shortlist, they'll have a telephonic interview. Telephonic interview will be with one of the directors. Basically, be a case. Can revolve around any product around you. My case was basically to identify the KPIs for WhatsApp, KPIs for success for WhatsApp. So, like, it can revolve around anything. Next to this would be the direct on-call interview. This telephonic interview will obviously result in the priority list through which they interview you on the December 1st. Apart from that, they have normal terms of four case interviews basically, involving around anything related to product. It can be as random as Google wants to enter some country and how should they enter, go to market strategy. From my experience, what helped me most was preparing for BCG, because I was already in close touch with how to break down a problem and go about solving it. So that is what I implemented the most. In addition to that, one more thing which most of these people recommended me us to do was go through some of the PM books. There are books related to how to crack a PM interview or what are the common questions that are asked in Google PM interviews. Just try to go through them and see how they are going about solving it. That will give you a familiarity with what are the kind of questions that can come to you when the actual interview happens. Yeah, so that's pretty much it. Any questions?